Good morning. Welcome once again to the Territorial Worship Service recorded here at Territorial Headquarters in Toronto. It truly is a joy each week to come and share with you in your homes, to celebrate together the goodness of God, worship Him, and hear from His Word. We're grateful this week to have joining with us as special guests, Captains Laura and Stefan van Schaik, who will minister to us from God's Word. Allow me to read these words from Psalm 113 as a call to worship for us as we commence today. Praise the Lord. Praise, O servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Let the name of the Lord be praised both now and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to the place where it sets, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The Lord is exalted over all the nations, His glory above the heavens. And so we come to exalt Him once again. May God indeed richly bless you as we worship together.
Let us pray. All good things come from you, O God. You created all this, and with love formed us in your image. When our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. All that we are, all that we have, is a trust from you, And so, in gratitude for all your gifts, we offer you ourselves and all that we have in union with Christ's offering to us. By your Holy Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Scripture today is John 13, verses 1 through 17. It was just before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave the world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The evening meal was in progress, and the devil had already prompted Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." "No," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no part with me." "Then, Lord," Simon Peter replied, "not just my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus answered, "Those who have had a bath need only wash their feet. Their whole body is clean. And you are clean, though not every one of you," for he knew who was going to betray him. And that was why he said not everyone was clean. When he had finished washing their feet, he put on his clothes and returned to his place. "Do you understand what I have done for you?" he asked them. "You call me teacher and Lord, and rightly so, for that is what I am. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also should wash one another's feet. I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. Very truly I tell you, no servant is greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him. Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them."
Shining, let us hold fast to you. as we await. Love to serve with joy and
if you're like me, then disinfectant wipes, hand soap, and sanitizer have become household staples in the same way milk, eggs, and bread are, and for good reason. If there's one thing this pandemic has reminded us of, it's the importance of hygiene and cleanliness. Throughout this pandemic, our world has received a hydrogen peroxide cleansing of mammoth proportion. But what I think we all need alongside this physical cleansing is a soul cleansing. Jesus offers both on the night he was betrayed. The gospel writer John indicates that Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. Jesus knew that Satan had already prompted Judas, son of Simon, to betray Jesus, and very shortly Jesus would be crucified. He is about to encounter a crisis moment, truly one of life and death, and his response is to cleanse. And so he gets up in the middle of the evening meal he is sharing with his disciples. He wraps himself in a towel, and he washes his disciples' feet. Now, I have a 5-year-old son, and I am constantly reminding him to not touch his feet at the dinner table because it is bad manners. It would have been similar in ancient times. While it was customary for a servant to wash guests' feet upon arriving to a home, this would have been done before everyone sat down to eat. The fact that Jesus does this in the middle of the meal doesn't so much indicate a poor host who has not provided the common courtesy of a foot wash upon arrival, but rather indicates that Jesus is intending to teach his disciples, and really teach us, an important lesson. See, in the world of Jesus, masters did not wash the feet of servants. Jesus was always about downward mobility. He was the king who entered the world as a peasant, the king who rode into Jerusalem on a colt instead of a noble steed, the king who would soon die a criminal's death on a cross. And here again, Jesus is modeling for us what truly makes someone great is service. Saint Bernard of Clairvaux, an 11th century French abbot, once said, "If you would be king in the Jesus way, it will not be with crown and scepter, but with basin and towel." When Jesus approaches the disciples, one of these men, Peter, is incredulous. He exclaims, "No, you shall never wash my feet." Jesus tries to assure Peter, but it doesn't seem to help. What's at the heart of Peter's comment here is pride. Jesus goes on to tell Peter that unless I wash you, you have no part with me. To have a part with Jesus means to have fellowship with him. And if we are not cleansed, Jesus says, we will not have fellowship with him. I don't know about you, but I often let my pride get in the way of allowing Jesus to cleanse and forgive me. The invitation Jesus offers his disciples is the same invitation he offers each of us, the invitation to let Jesus wash us today. And we should let Jesus wash us, not because we think or feel we deserve or need to be washed, but simply because Jesus wants to. He wants to cleanse us. There's a second invitation offered here also. Jesus goes on to explain why he has washed his disciples' feet. He says in verse 15, "I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. Very truly I tell you, No servant is greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him. Especially in these days of global crisis, as disciples of Jesus, we are called to wash one another's feet, to serve one another. It's true that serving in these days can be difficult, confusing, and exhausting. We are navigating these changes in uncertain times just like everyone else. We are grieving lost loved ones, and we are grieving lost opportunities. And yet, we are to follow the example of Jesus, who, on the eve of his crucifixion, did not throw in the towel, but instead chose to pick up the towel and wash his disciples' feet. And we can still find creative ways to wash feet, reach out hands, meet needs, because Jesus modeled this first to us. Anne Voskamp shares these words, and I share them with you today. Jesus laid aside both his heavenly glory and his outer garment to robe himself in humanity and wrap himself with a towel. He poured water into a bowl, like he will pour out his lifeblood on the cross, and he washes the filth from the feet of the disciples, like he washes the filth from my soul. It is no small thing to let Jesus wash your feet even now, to receive the touch of his towel, to receive impossible grace, to simply receive. God in human flesh took on the likeness of a servant to love the unlovely. So how could we live anything less than that of a servant? Because this is how we love and thank him. How can you not become one of the people of the towel when you yourself have been touched by the towel? Allow Jesus to cleanse you this day, and then allow him to hand you a towel so that you can go out to serve and love your neighbor. Blessings on you this day. Thank you.
cowardice, defend us from lethargy. Awake, all on thine errand send us to labor for thy sake. We go to all the world with kingdom hope unfold. No other name has power to save but Jesus Christ the Lord. We go to all the world with kingdom hope unfold. No other name has power to save.
Thank you, Megha, for sharing in that closing song with us, Facing a Task Unfinished. Well, thank you for sharing in worship with us this morning as we looked into God's Word. And allow me to share in a benediction taken from Numbers. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. May you have a great week. And may God's blessing be upon you as you bring blessing to someone else. Amen.